And this night is mentioned in the Quran in two surah. There is a whole surah by the name Surah Al-Qadr, and there is some mention of it in Surah Ad-Dukhan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr, laylatul qadri khayrun min alf shahr, تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. This surah is known to everybody, and Allah has mentioned in it that at or in or during that night, Allah has sent down the Quran from the preserved tablet and book to the Al-Bayt al-Ma'mur, to the Kaaba of the angels on the top of the seventh heaven, totally, completely. And then from there, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam was in charge to reveal it to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and to teach him and to keep him memorized the Quran, delivering that to the whole humanity after that. The second place where this night been mentioned is in Surah Ad-Dukhan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Hameen wal kitab al mubeen, inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakah, إِنَّا كُنَّا مُنذِرِينَ فِيهَا يُفْرَقُ كُلُّ أَمْرٍ حَكِيمٍ أَمْرًا مِنْ عِنْدِنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا مُرْسِلِينَ رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. This also, six verses started Surah Ad-Dukhan, mentioning the surah and what is in the surah. So both of these can give you full understanding of the importance of this night and what is in it. So roughly, we go in Surah Al-Qadr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said he sent down the Quran at that night. And then followed that with the question, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ, to draw attention to the greatness and significance of this night, put the question, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. You have no clue, you have no idea. You cannot imagine or think of half perspective of this night. And went on to explain, لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. This night is greater in virtues than 1,000 months or 83 years. What is in it? Allah has mentioned one thing, that the angels comes down to the earth, including Jibreel. تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحِ. Al-Ruh is Jibreel with the angels. فِيهَا, at that night, throughout the whole night. بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ, permission, by permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They come down with what? مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرِ, from every affairs and issues and orders and decrees related to humanity on this earth. Min kulli, and kull means everything, there is nothing left or was not included in the commands that Jibreel and the angels came down to the earth with it. And those affairs are peace, and it is continue until dawn. So, definitely, this surah has made it clear, this night is real great night, real important night, real unique night, and night deserve from us to dedicate time and seek it with sincerely, with obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Dukhan, Allah said, Hameem, that's two letters, والكتاب المبين سورد باي ذا كلير بوك ذا قران إنا أنزلناه في ليلة مباركة. Again, it was sent down in a blessed night, and إنا كنا منذرين. The purpose of that Quran sent down is to warn. فيها يفرق كل أمر حكيم. Again, in this night, يفرق means decrees, determined, separated, distinguished, all wise orders. Amran min indina, it's an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, inna kunna mursileen, we are sending messengers to humanity, carrying the rahmah of Allah to the humanity. So, we will start now going through the detail of it. Qadr means decree, and Qadr means measure. Qadr mean plan. Qadr mean ranks and honor. Qadr means narrow. Qadr means bless and blessings. All of these are basically the descriptions of Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr is all of these. No exceptions and not one of them. And it is called the night, as we said, the night of honor, the night of peace, the night of forgiveness, the night of the angels, the night of the earth, the night of blessings and goodness, the night of worship, the night of answered dua and replied to. So, and these are all just from the verses we recited. This night basically extend your worshipping age to be more than 83 years. Now, we count age by days and nights and hours and weeks and months. And this is not significant, honestly, because there are many who live so long, but they did nothing much for this dunya, for humanity, or for the deen, or for akhirah. The significance of your age, my age, is what did you accomplish? What did you deliver? What is your legacy? What is your impact on the world around you? This night is an opportunity for me and you that to achieve at least one thing, that is, as if we have worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 83 years. And we know worshiping Allah is very limited time. Five prayers a day, the total of it maybe hour or two. So less than a third of your age may be spent in worshiping Allah and the rest of it in daily affairs. Now here you get 12 hours only that you can, with it, extend your worshiping age to be more worthy, more than 83 years. Now, that is only if you receive Laylatul Qadr one time. But let's imagine, because you live 60 years, 70 years, let's imagine that you have received Laylatul Qadr 10 times. Then your worshipping age will become 830 years, more than that. If you received it 20 times in your lifetime, then you have been worshipping Allah for 1,660 years or more than that. So from here, that's why scholars and the Prophet said, "Man hurimaha faqad hurim." If you really deprive yourself from this great night and this great reward and this great time of worshipping Allah, definitely you are a loser in all aspects. Because what is count to Allah is the worship time spent in fulfilling the commandment of the Quran. The virtues of Laylatul Qadr are nine. Number one, In it, Allah has sent down the Quran. Second, Allah made the worship in it worthy greater than worshiping 83 years. Third, Jibril alayhi salam comes down to the earth with the malaika until fajr, until dawn. And we need to remember that Jibril used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam every year and more frequent. Whenever there was a need, Jibril used to come and visit the earth and talking to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After that, Jibril, we know only one time he comes to the earth by the permission of Allah, which is during the night of Qadr. And his job to come and check on us what we have done to the Quran. Where is the Quran in our life? And that's why Jibril comes every night. So the loser is the great loser, or the true loser is the one who lose this night, who lived 6 years, got chance every year to receive Laylatul Qadr, and he didn't get it even one time. The Prophet ﷺ said, whosoever stay up that night, iman and wahtisaba, believing and expecting the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his past sin will be forgiven. Seventh, has a surah by its name. Eighth, as Allah said, فِيهَا يُفْرَقُ كُلُّ أَمْرٍ حَكِيمٍ. This night is the night of revealing the plan of humanity and the earth and the universe for the angels who are in charge of it to execute it throughout the coming year. And closing books of deed and affairs of the passing year. And finally, this night is only a gift, special gift for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Allah wants to favor you, to honor you, to give you a greatest gift, which is 12 hours greater than 83 years. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, min kulli amrin salam. It is clear that night Allah does not allow evil or harm to be let go. Does not decree that, nor allow harm and evil to occur on earth. And that's why, min kulli amrin salam. The reason was this night given to the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is, as we know from hadith, that the Sahaba was mentioned to them, prophets and righteous people in previous nations used to worship Allah 8 years with sin free. One of them is Zakaria, as it was mentioned in the hadith that he worshiped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 80 years sin free, never done anything, even small sin. So the Sahaba felt sad and felt that they cannot compete, they cannot win, they cannot be the best ummah in the day of judgment, ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are giving the night that will compensate, will actually elevate, will make you surpass all the righteous people before you. Now, we know Allah has kept this night secret for our own good, that we spend the month of Ramadan thanking Him for Islam, fasting, praying, and thanking Him for the Quran, and studying and teaching and understanding the Quran, and also receiving the night of Al-Qadr. So the plan of Allah, the intention of Allah to keep it secret, and you strive, you struggle, you behave, you surrender, you submit, you pray, you ask for it, and Allah, if He sees me or you worth it, deserve it, He will grant it to you. And it is granted to everybody, whether you are in the masjid or not in the masjid, whether you are in a state of purity or not. Women, they are not in a state of purity, they will receive it. People at field, at travel ship or airplanes or at the post defending Islam and Muslims anywhere. It is no restriction to who can get it because of place or time restrictions. It is who are you and whether Allah see me or you deserve it, and it will be granted to that person. Definitely, there are some hadith mentioned about the signs of it. Someone maybe in the next talk will talk about this. But we got to mention a few things that the following people are not going to receive Laylatul Qadr. Number one, somebody has shirk. Somebody does not believe in Allah the way he should be believed. Somebody lack the knowledge of who is Allah and what is your relationship to him. So shirk by any means or any way. And the greatest shirk is calling that he has a son. Those who worship idols, this is shirk, but this is less, way less than associating son to God, because the son carries the quality, the attribute, the characters, the power of the father. And so you are claiming that the greatest claim, making the whole creations of Allah extremely angry. تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْ وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدَّ أَنْ دَعَوْ لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدَ. This is something beyond imagination and accepted. We said anybody worship a cow or an idol, it's a shirk, but it cannot be equal to the shirk calling Allah as son. Number two, the one who is rebellious against his parents, definitely, no matter how much good it is doing or she, there is no way they can receive Laylatul Qadr. Fourth, al-shahna'u wal-baghdha, the fight, the anger, the hatred among brothers and sisters, making Laylatul Qadr not possible to go their way. In the transgressor and those who commit injustice, whether to themselves, to their family, spouses, to their employee, to their animals, to their neighbors, these are not going to receive Laylatul Qadr. And so we finally say that those who are rejecting the plan of Allah, where Allah said, I'm going to keep it secret, and I'm going to select whom to be bestowed on him. Those who are rejecting this plan and trying to waste time to figure it out, definitely they are not going to get it. And if anyone able to get it would be the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but he did not get it. Or the righteous Sahaba who were giving the glad tidings of Jannah, or the companions who Allah was pleased with them, none of them was able to uncover it and determine when. So we are not greater than them in value to Allah nor in our righteousness. No one can tell me or tell you that he can figure it out or he knows when it is. These are liars. And when we look to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are many, many, many hadith that are authentic. For odd night and even night, for night from the beginning to Ramadan until the end of Ramadan, it is only to tell you it is in Ramadan and you better seek it properly and appropriately. May Allah guide us, may Allah enable us to receive Laylatul Qadr, and may Allah honor us with it so we can be sin free and inshallah meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sin free. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.